Hello and once again welcome back to the channel. So today in this video we will start the chapter of simultaneous equations, which is the chapter number 2 of AdMaths. Chapter number 1, which is sets, has been excluded from the 2021 AdMaths syllabus, so we will not do it. We will just start from chapter number 2, which is simultaneous equation. For those who are new to the channel, let me tell you, this is a free AdMaths course being offered by Academia 101, which is a free platform for students where they can access to different free courses and resources like notes, past papers, different books, etc., all for free. So without wasting any more time, let's start with our video. Okay, so simultaneous equation. Now what are simultaneous equation? To understand them, we have to first understand what does simultaneous mean. So simultaneous, as you guys can see on the screen, means occurring, operating, or done at the same time. Now so what does simultaneous equations mean? Simultaneous equations means two equations that have to be solved at the same time. So for example, let's start. So for example, we have to solve the simultaneous equation 2x plus y is equal to 5, comma x plus 2y is equals to 7. Now how will you solve the simultaneous equation? Well, the very easy way to solve the simultaneous equation is by substitution. Now what do I mean by substitution? Well, the substitution means you either make y or either x in any one of these equations your subject. Alright, you make x or y your subject. You can either choose this equation or you can choose this equation. It's up to you. Okay, so for example, if I choose this equation first, this one, okay, and I make y my subject. So if I'm making y my subject, this will be y is equal to 5 minus 2x, right? Because this 2x was positive over here, when it will go to the other side of the equation, it will become negative. So now I have the value of y. In the same way, if I would have to make x my subject, how would I have done it? Well, I would have done it in the same way. 2x is equal to 5 minus y, okay, and then x is equals to 5 minus y over 2. So this is my value of x. Now what is the next step? Well, now you have the value of x. What you will do is that you will substitute this value of x in this equation, that is your second equation. Now what does substitute means? It means that you will place the value of x in this equation. So 5 minus y over 2 plus 2y is equal to 7, right? Now we will solve this. So we know that we will have to take LCM over here. This will be 5 minus y plus 4y, and it will be over 2. It will be over 2 is equal to 7. This 2 will multiply with 7, so this will become 5 minus y plus 4y is equal to 14, right? Now let's send this 5 with 14. So it was positive over here, and it will go to the other side of the equation, it will become negative, right? And 4 minus y is 3y, so this will become 3y is equal to 14 minus 5, that is 9, right? Now the value of y would be y equals to 9 divided by 3. So 3 ones are 3, 3 threes are 9. Our value of y is 3. Okay, now is this our final answer? No, this isn't our final answer. Why? Because we only have the value of y, we do not have the value of x. So to take out the value of x, what will we do? We will simply place the value of y, which is 3, in this. Okay, so we know that x is equal to 5 minus y. Y is equal to 3, so we'll place 3 over 2. So x is equal to 5 minus 3 is 2 over 2 is 1. So x is equal to 1. So now we have our value of x and we have our value of y. So this is how you solve a simultaneous equation. Now let's see some other examples. Okay, so here we have another equation where 4x plus 3y is equal to 8, and then we have the other equation where 2y minus 3x is equal to 11. Now we are going to do the same like we did earlier. We will either make x our subject or y our subject. So in the earlier case I made x the subject, now let's make y the subject. Okay, so 3y is equal to 8 minus 4x, right? And then y, we know that 3 is multiplying with y over here, and when it will come to the other side it will divide, right? So y equals to 8 minus 4x over 3. Now we have the value of y. Now we have the value of y. Okay, now we are going to substitute this value of y in this equation. We know that 2y, y is 8 minus 4x. So 8. So 8 minus 4x over 3 minus 3x is equal to 11. Right, now let's solve this. So 8 2s are 16 plus minus minus, and 4 2s are 8x over 3 minus 3x is equal to 11. Right, now we have to take the LCM, so this will become 16 minus 8x minus 9x is equal to 11, and this will be over 3. Now 3 would go and multiply with 11 over here, so this will become 16 minus, minus minus is plus, so 9 plus 8 is 17x, right? And this will become 11 multiplied by 3 is 33. Okay, so let's see, we have minus 17x is equals to 33 minus 16. This 16 was positive, and it will go to the other side of the equation, it will become negative. So 33 minus 16 is 17, right? So we have minus 17x is equal to 17. So finally we will have x is equal to 17 over minus 17, right? So 17 minus 17, so we will have x is equals to minus 1. So this is the value of x. Now let's put this value of x in this cube over here and see what our value of y would be. So y is equal to 8 minus 4 minus 1 over 3. So y is equal to 8 minus, minus minus is plus, right? So 4 ones are 4 over 3. 8 plus 4 is 12, and 12 divided by 3 is 12 divided by 3 is 3 ones are 3, 3 fours are 12. So we have the value of y as y equals to 4. So now I hope you have understood how to solve simultaneous equation. Now I'm giving you a simultaneous equation, and then you can pause the video, try to solve it first yourself, and then I'm going to solve it for you, and you can see if you're getting the right answer or not. So the equation is 4x plus 3y is equal to 8, and the other equation is 2y minus 3x is equal to 11. So this is the equation. Now pause the video, try to solve it first by yourself, and then you can resume the video to see if your answer were correct. Okay, so now you guys would have solved the equation, and now let me solve it and you guys can then check your answers. So I will make x the subject over here. So 4x is equal to 8 minus 3y, and x is equal to 8 minus 3y over 4. So if you guys have made even y the subject over here, so that will be correct. You will get the answer correct in both ways. Now I'm going to put the value of x in this equation, right? So that would be 2y minus 3. X is 8 minus 3y over 4 is equal to 11. It will be 2y minus plus minus 3 is 24. Minus minus plus 3 is 9y over 4 is equal to 11. Now you know that we have to take LCM, so this would become 8y, right? I hope you know why this have become 8y, because 2y had 1 below it, right? And when we take the LCM of 1 and 4, we get 4. So 1 multiplied by 4 and 2 multiplied by 4 is 8. Minus 24 plus 9y over 4 is equal to 11. Eight y minus 24 plus 9y is equals to 11 multiplied by 4, which is 44. Okay, so this would be 8y plus 9y, right? 8y plus 9y is 17y is equals to 44 plus 24, right? Because this was minus 24, and when it will go to the other side of the equation, it will become positive 24. So 44 plus 24 is 40, 50, 60, 64, 68. So we have 17y is equals to 68. And y is equal to 68 over 17. So y is equal to 4. Okay, so y is equal to 4. Now we are going to put the value of y in this to get a value of x. So x is equals to 8 minus 3y, which is 4 over 4. So x is equal to 8 minus 4 is a 12 over 4. So we know that x is equal to 8 minus 12 is 4 minus 4 over 4. So the value of x would be minus 1, right? So this is the value of x and y for this simultaneous equation. If you guys have got it correct, then well done. If not, you can always correct your mistake by seeing my solution, and you can find where did you make mistake and make sure that you do not repeat it. Now let's try a trickier question. So for example, if we had a question where they have given you the value of x and y, okay, that is 2 and 3, and they have given you two equations, simultaneous equation, that is ax plus by is equal to 1 and ay minus bx is equal to 8, and they have told you to find the value of a and b. Okay, so how will you solve it? Well, it's very easy. We will obviously put first the value of x and y in the equation. So for example, if I put the value of x and y in the first equation, this will become 2a plus 3b is equal to 1, right? In the same way, if we put the value of x and y in the second equation, it will become 3a minus 2b is equal to 8. So now you should stop the video and try to solve it yourself first, and then you can follow up to see if you got your answer correct. Okay, so now let's start doing it. So I'm going to make a my subject over here. So this would be 2a plus 3b is equal to 1. 2a is equal to 1 minus 3b. So a would be 1 minus 3b over 2. This will be the value of a. Now we are going to substitute the value of a in the second equation, right? So this would be 1 minus 3b over 2 minus 2b is equal to 8, right? Now let's simplify it. So this would be 3 minus 3 plus minus is minus, 3 3 is 9b over 2 minus 2b is equal to 8. Now we will take the LCM. So this will become 3 minus 9b minus 4b is equal to 8 over 2. Right? This 2 will now multiply by 8. So this will become 3 minus 9b minus 4b is equal to 16. Now let's move down. So this would be minus minus is plus, so 9 plus 4 is 13b, and the sign would be of minus. So 16 minus 3, so minus 13b is equal to 13. So b is equal to 13 over minus 13. So our answer would be b equals to minus 1. So we have got our first value, that is the value of b. Now we will place the value of b over here to get the value of a. So a is equal to 1 minus 3 minus 1 over 2. So this will be 1 minus minus is plus, 3 1 is 3 over 2. So a is equals to 1 plus 3 is 4 over 2. 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 4. So a is equal to 2. So now we have both the value of a and of b. So this was our overall answer. So till now we have seen what our simultaneous equation. We have solved simultaneous equation. Now we are going to see some different type of question that can come in the paper of simultaneous equations. So for example, if we have a question where y square minus 4x is equal to 0, okay, and 2x plus y is equal to 4, okay. Now they say to solve the equation, to find the value of x and y. Now one thing that you should note is that if I take this equation at and make y my subject, how am I going to do it? Because you can see that we have y square over here, right? So let's see how we can solve this, how we can make y our subject over here. So for example, if y square is equal to 4x, then y would be under root 4x, right? Because to make y the subject, we have to finish this square, right? We have to remove this square. And to remove the square, we have only one way, that is to take under root on both sides. Because if we take under root over here, we have to take it on the other side as well. This is the rule of general maths. So we have to take square root over here as well, alright. Now we know that square root always cancel with square, so we will have y is equal to under root 4x. So this is going to be our value of y, which we can substitute in this equation to get the value of x. But don't you think that this will become a little more complicated, right? Because you have to put under root 4x in this equation, and there are more chances that you can make mistake. So let's try another way. Let's try making x or y the subject in this equation rather than this equation, okay? So let's try this. So in this equation we have 2x plus y is equal to 4. So if I make, for example, y my subject over here, so this will become y is equals to 4 minus 2x, right? So now I have the value of y equals to 4 minus 2x. Now what I'm going to do is to put the value of y equals to 4 minus 2x in the first equation. So for the first equation is y square, which means 4 minus 2x square minus 4x is equal to 0, right? So now you know that 4 minus 2x square is a minus b square, right? And I hope you guys know that the way to expand a minus b square is a square minus 2ab plus b square. Okay, so now we know that 4 minus 2x square will open as 4 square minus 2ab plus b square, right? And then minus 4x is equal to 0. So now let's solve this. We know that 4 4s are 16, minus 4 2s are 8, and 8 2s are 16. So this will be 16x plus 2 2s are 4, and x will be square. Minus 4x is equal to 0. So now let's simplify this. So 4x square will remain as 4x square, and minus minus will become plus, so 16 plus 4 is 20x, and the sign will be of the greater value, and plus 16 would come like this, is equal to 0. Now we have to solve this by middle term breaking. So we are going to solve this by middle term, but one thing that we can see is that 4 is common. We can take 4 common over here, right? So we will take 4 common. This will become x square minus 5x plus 4 is equal to 0. This 4 is multiplying. When it will go to the other side of the equation, it will divide, right? And 0 divided by 4 is 0. So we will have the equation x square minus 5x plus 4 is equal to 0. Now it has become easier to apply the middle term breaking, right? Now we can apply it. So we know that this will become x square minus x minus 4x plus 4 is equal to 0. We can take x common here, so this will become x minus 1, and we can take minus 4 common here, this will become x minus 1 is equal to 0. So we have x minus 1 and x minus 4 is equal to 0. So the two values that we have of x is x is equal to 1 and x is equal to 4. Okay, so these are our two values of x. Now simple, we are going to substitute both the values of x in our equation and find the value of y. So what were our values of x? We had the values of x. Our values of x were 1 and 4. Okay, so our equation was, as you can see, y equals to 4 minus 2x. So y is equals to 4 minus 2x. Now we are going to put the value of x in this, so this will become y minus 4 minus 2 multiplied by 1. This is the first value, and the second value is y equals to 4 minus 2x. In this case we'll put 4. Okay, now let's solve this. So this will become 4 minus 4 to the 8, and 4 minus 8 is minus 4. So this is our first value of y, and the second value of y will be 4y is equals to 4 minus plus minus 2 ones are 2, and 4 minus 2 is 2, so y equals to 2. So these are our two values of y, and these are our two values of x. Okay, now let's see another example of the equation where we have x plus y is equals to 5, and the second one is x plus 1 square plus y plus 1 square is equals to 25. So obviously the very first step that everyone would prefer to do is to make y or x subject in the first equation, right? Because this is easy. So let's say I take y as my subject, so this will become y equals to 5 minus x. Okay, now what am I going to do? I'm going to substitute this value in the second equation, in this. Okay, so this will be x plus 1 square plus 5 minus x plus 1 square is equals to 25. So x plus 1 square we know will expand with the formula of a plus b square, right? So this will be x a square plus 2 a b plus b square plus, let's simplify it first, 5 plus 1 is 6 minus x square is equals to 25. So this will be x square plus 2x plus 1 plus a square minus 2ab plus b square is equals to 25, right? Because this is also a minus b square, and this was also a plus b square. So we know that a plus b square or a minus b square open in the same way, a square plus 2ab plus b square, and this opens as a square minus 2ab plus b square. So the only difference is that we add plus over here in case of plus, and if it is minus, a minus b, then we place minus over here. This is the only difference. Rest of the formula is the same to expand this. Alright, so a plus b square we have spent it in this way, and a minus b square we have spent it in this way. Now let's simplify it. This will be x square plus 2x plus 1 plus 6 6 are 36 minus 6 to the 12 x plus x square is equals to 25. So this is the equation that we got, and now we have to simplify it even further. So this will become 2x square, plus minus is minus, so this will become 10x with the sign of negative, and plus minus is minus. 37 minus 25 is plus 12 is equals to 0. This can be further solved with middle term breaking, but first you have to see if you can take anything common. So yes, you guys have guessed it correctly. We can take 2 common over here, so this will become x square minus 5x plus 6 is equals to 0, and this 2 is multiplying over here. When it will go to the other side of the equation, this will divide. Okay, so 0 divided by 2 is 0, we know that, right? So equation that we will get is x square minus 5x plus 6 is equals to 0. Now we can apply the middle term breaking in it, so this will become x square minus 3x minus 2x plus 6 is equals to 0, and we can take x common over here, so this will become x minus 3, and we can take minus 2 common over here, so this will become x minus 3 is equals to 0. Alright, so we have x minus 3 and x minus 2 is equals to 0. Okay, so this is as x is equals to 3 and x is equals to 2. These are our two values of x. Now we have to place these two values of x in the equation to find the value of y. So now let's move back and see that we had y equals to 5 minus x as our equation. So we will write it over here, y equals to 5 minus x, alright? And the two values of x that we have are x is equals to 3 and x is equals to 2. So let's write it over here, x is equals to 3 and x is equals to 2. Now we will put these two values of x in this equation to find the two values of y. So y equals to 5 minus 3, the first case, and the second case is y equals to 5 minus 2. So this will become y equals to 3, and this will become y equals to 2. Alright, so these are the two values of y, and these are the two values of x. And now I hope you guys have understood how to solve this simultaneous equation. I have done both the easy equation as well as the difficult equation. So the last equation for today to solve is x minus 5y is equal to 8, and x square plus 9y square plus 3x is equal to 30 plus xy. So this is the equation. Now I know it seems a little tricky, but it is easy, trust me. So what you can do is pause the video and first try to solve it yourself, and then you can follow my solution to see if you got it correct. Okay, so now let's see how we can solve this equation. So first of all, obviously all of you would have make x or y as your subject in the first equation because this is easy. So yes, I will do the same. I would make x my subject. So x is going to be 8 plus 5y. Alright, so our first part is done. Now our second part is obviously to substitute x in the second value. This is exactly what we are going to do. Alright, so let's just place it, 8 plus 5y square plus 9y square plus 3x, which is 8 plus 5y, okay, is equals to 30 plus x, which is 8 plus 5y multiplied by y. Okay, now let's try to expand it. So we know that a plus b square expands with a square plus 2ab plus b square, right? So we are going to expand it in the same way. This is going to be a square plus 2ab plus b square, okay? And plus 9y square is going to come as it is. This 3 is multiplying with 8 plus 5y, so we will multiply it. So this will become plus 3 8s are 24 plus 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 5 3s are 15 y is equal to 30 plus this y is multiplying with 8 plus 5y, so this will become 8y plus 5y square. Alright, okay, now let's simplify it. So 8 8s are 64 plus 8 2 plus 5 2s are 10 and 10 8s are 80. So 80y plus 5 5 is 25y square plus 9y square plus 24 plus 15, and now we are going to bring these to the other side of the equation so that we could have a single equation, right? So this will become minus 30 minus 8y and minus 5y square is equal to 0. Now let's simplify it even further. Okay, now let's simplify it. So what we can do is first bring all the value of y square together, right? So we are going to put first 25y square plus 9y square minus 5y square. Then the next step is to bring the values of y together. Okay, so this will be plus 80y plus 15y minus 8y. Okay, and the third is to bring the values with no coefficient, the simple values together. So this will become plus 64 plus 80 minus 30 is equals to 0. Okay, so now let's simplify it. So we know that 25 plus 9, so now we are going to Now let's see. So 25 plus 9 is 34, and 34 minus 5 is 29. So we have 29y square. All right. Now plus 80y plus 15y is plus 95y, and plus 95y minus 8y is plus 87y. So we have plus 87y over here. Now plus 64 plus 24 is plus 88, and plus 88 minus 30 is 58. So plus 58 is equal to 0. So this is our final equation. Now obviously we have to do the middle term breaking, but first we have to see if we can take anything common. Yes, we can take 29 common. So this will become y square plus 3y plus 2 is equals to 0. Alright, 29 is multiplying. When it will go to the other side of the equation, it will divide with 0, and so our final equation will be y square plus 3y plus 2 is equals to 0. Okay, so now we will middle term break. We will apply the middle term breaking. So this will become y square plus 2y plus y plus 2 is equals to 0. We can take y common. So y plus 2 plus 1, y plus 2 is equals to 0. So the two values of y that we have is y plus 1 is equals to 0, and y plus 2 is equals to 0. So the final value of y is minus 1 and minus 2, right? So these are our final values of y. Okay, so this is it. Now we have completed the last question 8 as well. Wait, have we? No, because we haven't taken out the value of x. We have only taken out the value of y, and now we will put this value of y in this equation to find the value of x. So we know that x is equal to 8 plus 5y. So we are going to write it over here. X is equal to 8 plus 5y, and the two values of y that we got are minus 1 and minus 2, right? Yes. So now let's just put the values of y to take out the value of x. So 8 plus 5 minus 1 is the first case, and the second case is x is equal to 8 plus 5 minus 2, right? So this will become x is equal to 8 plus minus is minus, and 5 twos are 10. So 8 minus 10 is minus 2. So this is our first value, and our second value is x is equal to 8 plus minus is minus, 5 minus is 5. So x is equal to 8 minus 5 is 3. So this is the two values of x, and this is the two values of y. So I hope now you guys are capable enough to do these types of questions. In the next video, we are going to see different variations of questions related to this topic that could come in the paper. And I will also like to add that if you guys have any question, or if you guys have not understood anything in the video, you can always comment, or you can send us the picture of the question on our email that you can find on the about section of this page, and we will try to reply to you as soon as